Morning students, today in this video we will discuss our part 2. In the part 1 we discussed about habitat and adaptations, is not it? And body covering also. So today we will discuss about breathing organs. You see, different animals have different types of breathing organs. Okay, they breathe in different way, is not it? Like we human have lungs, fishes have gills, and some animal breathe through their skin, is not it? So different animals have different organs for breathing. So first we will discuss about skin, how they breathe through skin. You see, some animals like earthworm, frogs. Let us take an example of earthworm. Okay, you may have seen earthworm have very soft and moist skin, is not it? So they breathe through their skin. How? You see, they breathe through the process of diffusion. Diffusion means they will take up oxygen directly from the environment. Okay? And they will release carbon dioxide. We human also, what we do? We take oxygen, is not it? And we breathe out what? Carbon dioxide. So likewise, they breathe out carbon dioxide through their moist skin. Okay? And frog also, they breathe through their skin when they are inside the water. Okay? Frog can breathe through many organs like their skin, nostrils. Again, they have lungs also. Okay? Now, breathing through body surfaces. You see what happens, some microscopic organism. Microscopic means they are very smaller in size, very tiny organisms. They are made up of only one cell, single cell. For example, amoeba, paramecium. What happens? They are made up of only one cell. Okay, so they don't have any respiratory organ for breathing. Okay, so what they do? They directly take up oxygen from the environment and release carbon dioxide in the environment. Okay, they take, they breathe through their body surface. Their body surface, whole body is only made up of single cell, is not it? So they breathe through it and they breathe out through the same body. Okay, now you see, breathing through the gills. See, usually fishes, prawns, they breathe through their gills. Gills are present in this region. You may have seen in the fishes, is not it? When your mommy brings fish from the market, just look at it, okay? You will find here gills. Okay, now you see what happened. Fish lives in water, is not it? So what happened, you see? Fishes, they take up the water from their mouth and they releases the water through the gills, okay? At that time, these gills, they absorb the oxygen which is dissolved in water. Okay, they cannot take oxygen from the environment, is not it? They cannot come outside and breathe like us. So they take up the dissolved oxygen which is present in the water and it is absorbed by the gills. Okay, insects like cockroach, grasshoppers, their body, suppose I am drawing a cockroach here, it may not be perfect, but somewhat like this cockroach. Okay, so what happened, you see? Over their body, in the lining of their body, there are several holes present, okay, called spiracles. And through these spiracles, they take oxygen and they release carbon dioxide, okay? The carbon dioxide, which is produced inside our body, through lungs, it comes outside via nose, okay? So, what happened, you see, carbon dioxide which is produced inside our body is exhaled outside from the same nostrils, is not it? Okay, so these are all about the organs of breathing. So, what we learned? Skin and body surface and then gills, spiracles and lungs, is not it? Students, now we will discuss about organs for movement. Okay, see, animals move around in search of food and shelter. They move from one place to another in search of food and shelter, is not it? To look after their mate and to escape from their enemy, to search their mate and escape from their enemies. Okay, if they remain in one place, they cannot walk. What will happen? A lion or tiger will come and it will eat them up, is not it? So they have well developed organ for movement. Usually some animals, like on land. Move with the help of legs. Okay. Two at the front. They are called what? Four limbs. They usually have four legs. It's not animals have four legs. In front two, on the back side two. So the two front legs are called four limbs. Okay. And the two at the back called hind limbs. Kangaroos and frogs are called leapers. Okay. They can jump. Is not it? They have well-developed hind limb and short forelimb. They have well-developed hind limb. They have well-developed hind limb. Hind limb means back legs. Is not it? And short forelimbs. Short front legs. Okay? And monkeys live on tree and are good climbers. You may have seen that monkeys are good climbers. They can easily jump from one branch of tree to another. Is not it? They have opposable thumb on hold onto the branches. They possess a prehensile tail which coils around the branches and support them in climbing. Now, here you will get two terms. Opposable thumb. Opposable thumb means they can fold their thumb easily. Okay, in the branches. Suppose you see this is the branches they can hold. Okay, suppose this is their hand, they can fold it easily. On the other hand, they have very long and slender tail which help them to coil. Coil means coiling over the branches which help them to climb easily. Okay, now you see snail and slugs. They have long muscular, foot. Okay, with the help of which they walk. Is not it? And what happened, you see, they secrete a slimy substance called mucus, a very slippery substance called mucus, which helps them to walk in a rough surface, okay, which helps them to walk easily on rough surfaces. Now you see some insects like centipedes. Why they are termed centipedes, you know, because they have 100 legs. Centi means 100, okay. So what happened, they have large number of legs which help them to walk very fast, okay. Now we will see organs for movement in aquatic animals. See, aquatic animals such as fish move in water with the help of fins and tail. With the help of fins and tail, they move, okay, inside the water. See, mammals such as dolphin, whale and porpoise have their forelimbs modified into flippers. Seals and penguins also swim with the help of their flippers. Okay, their hind limb. What I told you about hind limb, the front leg. Okay, so in this dolphin, whale, penguin, seal, what happened? Their forelimb is modified into flipper. Okay, which help them to swim in water. Okay, see the web feet of frog help them to swim. Alligator and crocodile use their leg as paddles and use their tail for swimming. Now you see what happened. Web feet. Like this. You may have seen feet of frog. It looks like this. Which help them to swim in the water. On the other hand, this alligators and crocodiles, they have legs. It's not it. They use their legs as paddles. And for swimming, they use their tail. Okay? Which pushes them forward. When they use their legs, it pushes them forward. Okay? And with the help of their tail, they can swim easily in water. Okay? Now you see, octopus, cuttlefish and squid move by jet propulsion. Jet propulsion means what happened, you know? See, suppose octopus, okay? They will take up the water. They will take up the water and they will release it in a great force. Okay, they will release it with great force. As soon as they release the water, what happens? The water moves backward with a great force and it pushes them forward. Okay, in this way they move. Okay, students, now we will discuss about movement in birds. You see, birds fly with the help of their wings. Is not it? So wings are nothing but modified forelimbs which are covered with feathers. Okay, the wings also have strong muscles that assist the bird in their flight. In their flight means wings also have strong muscles which help them in flying. Okay, flight means in moving. The muscles are called flight muscles. So flight muscles are present in wings. Okay, the wings of hummingbird is very small and beat very fast. Okay, the wings of hummingbird is very small and it beats very fast. Because of that only, while sucking the nectar also, you will see them, their wings are in movement. Okay. The eagles have broad wings which help them to glide in air. So eagles, you may have seen how they fly without flapping, is not it? Their wings are very broad, which help them to glide without flapping for long time. Okay. Now movement in reptiles. So what comes under? So what comes under reptiles? Lizards, snakes, crocodiles. Okay. See, animals such as lizard and crocodile crawl using their short legs. So lizard and crocodile, they have very short legs. You may have seen, but snakes, do they have legs? Snake don't have legs. So how do they move? They move with the help of their scale and flexible backbone. Okay, their backbone is very flexible. You may have seen when a snake moves, it can move like this. Is not it? They have a layer of scale over their body, which is quite slip. Okay, it is very slippery. So the snakes have a layer of scale over their body, and their backbone are flexible, because of which they can move fast. Now the last one is movement in human being. So how we human being move? See, for walking we use our hind limb, that is legs. Not it to move from one place to another, we use our hind limb, that is leg. And to hold an object, to ride something, we use our forelimb. With the help of our forelimb only we are able to ride or hold things. So what is our forelimb? Our hand is our forelimb. So is it clear? Now our last topic is migration. So what do you understand by the term migration? You see, the movement of animal in a very large group from one place to another in search of food, shelter or mate is called what? Migration. Okay. Some birds migrate during winter season. See, some birds are present which migrate, which comes from very far place like Antarctica, some polar region, because in winter season it is very cold there. Okay. So they move to our places where they get warmth as well as food also. Okay. Siberian white crane or snow crane migrate to India during winter from western Siberia. Siberia is a very cold place. Okay. So in search of food and warmth, they move from Siberia to India. Some insects such as monarch butterfly migrate during winter from Canada to Mexico. Salmons, a type of fish, migrate from sea to very long distance to lay their eggs in river. So salmons, it is a type of fish. Okay. So what happens? They lay their eggs in fresh water. So we know that sea water is salty. Okay. So what they do to lay their eggs in fresh water? They come very long distance. Okay. In the rivers to lay their eggs. Okay. So students, our video ends here. I hope you have understood many things from this video. Thank you and have a good day ahead.